How you guys doing today? I'm Xavier Tillman, and today I'm going to convince you guys why you should spank your kids when later in the future you guys might have kids. Why you should spank them later in the future. So first, what happens if you don't spank your kid? There's three things that happen. One, they're going to throw repetitive tantrums. Two, they're not going to respect you as an adult or other adults. And three, they behave however they want to when they get older, and they think that there's no consequences in their actions. So tantrums. First off, a tantrum is when a child, or anybody really, flops on the ground and throws their hands and scream and cry. And basically, they cause attention. And it's really embarrassing for a parent because it shows other parents that they don't really have control over their children. So I got a quick video to, if you guys don't know what a tantrum looks like, real quick, just 20 seconds. But as you can see, it was very embarrassing for the parent because all the other families are walking by looking at it like, oh, look at your kid, you can't control it. So by whooping a child, it allows them to know that they need to respect you as an adult and to basically have more self-control for themselves. Also, kids won't respect parents. So for instance, how many of you guys call your parents by their first name? For those of you that don't, it's out of respect and out of love for your parents. That's why you don't do it. And if a child does call the parents by their first name, it allows them to have sort of a friendship instead of a parent-child relationship. And with a friendship, friends are allowed to talk negatively towards each other or diss each other. And if a child is talking negatively to a parent, it's just not allowed and it's not supposed to happen. So, the last thing that happens if you don't spank your child is they have listening problems. And I'm not talking about the listening problems that are like, you know, hearing aids or anything. I'm talking about like they have control over where they're just going to ignore you as a parent. And if a child doesn't listen to parents, how are they going to listen to someone with authority, say a police officer or a teacher or a principal, anything like that? So if they're not going to respect you as a parent, how are they going to respect other adults? And for example, a parent knows when a child needs to go to bed because they know that a child would need 9 hours to wake up in the morning, so they're not cranky or anything like that. A child just wants to stay up and be active and just have fun all night long. But the reason that a child needs to be whooped in that case is to, hey, I need you to go to bed because you don't know that you need your 9 hours of sleep, but I do. And so since you won't listen to me, I need to whoop you so that you need to lay down. And another cleanup example would be, say, for instance, I have a daughter, she's 11 months, but obviously she's 11 months, so she can't really clean up after herself. But when she gets older, I have to make sure that I let her know that whenever she makes a mess or finishes eating, that she has to put her dishes in the sink and she has to take care of her stuff like that. So if she doesn't listen to me and says, you know what, mom's gonna handle it, or no, you handle it, then I have to let her know, like, hey, no, you gotta take care of your stuff and you can't depend on other people to take care of stuff for you. So, since we're talking so negatively about whooping, here are the benefits of spanking your child. Your child will make less mistakes in the same areas. Your child will have more control over their impulses, and they're going to respect adults' authority, say police officers or teachers. So first, talking about making mistakes in the same area. So say your child is running around the house, just having fun. They turn the corner, boom, they knock over a $500 vase, and you're just like, for real? And so the reason that you have to whoop your child is not because you're angry that they just broke a $500 vase, but it's to let them know that, hey, now there's glass on the floor and you can't run around the house because there's a lot of dangerous things that you could run into and you could get hurt. And that's the main reason that you'd whoop them. You wouldn't whoop them because, I don't know, they broke something really expensive to you, even though it might hurt a little bit because it's so expensive. And my personal example is when I was 10 years old, me and my mom went to Walmart. And as soon as we got in there, I ran to the video game aisle just so I could play some demo video games, mostly sports though, like football or FIFA or basketball, whatever. So as I'm back there, I hear my mom yelling my name, but I'm not calling her because I know where she, or I'm not walking towards her because I know where she is because I can hear her. But she has no clue where I am because I'm focused on the game and I'm not saying anything back. So So when she ran into me and she found me, the first thing she did was snatch me up and she whooped me. And I was crying. I'm like, I'm sorry, what did I do, what did I do? And she just told me, well, I'm so scared when I don't know where you are that you need to let me know where you're going before you leave. And I can't see you all the time, so you just have to stay next to me. And from that point on, I was like, okay, you got it. I'm just gonna sit next to you. So I and impulse control. Knowing that there are consequences for controlling impulses will give children the mindset to not do the wrong thing. For instance, if a brother and sister are fighting each other, or just even yelling at each other, and the brother decides, you know what, I'm gonna hit her, and he hits his sister. He needs to know that there's gonna be consequences later on, like domestic violence, if he's hitting women. And by spanking the brother after he does something like that and letting him know you can't hit girls at all, and not just your mom or your sister, but any girls in general, lets him know that, okay, I can't do that or else I'm gonna get in big trouble, not just with my mom, but with the law. And this is a quote from Taylor Lucy. She's just a regular mom, and she said, so often we see stories in the news of children and teens that don't respect the law, nor those who uphold them. This is often enough to get them into trouble, and when they get into it, many young people with this attitude can't get out of it. And the reason they can't get out of trouble is because their parents never tell them if they're doing something wrong. And so, say for instance, if a child is graffitiing the wall or whatever, and their parents never tell them it's the wrong thing to do, when they get in trouble with the police, they're gonna think, oh, well, my parents didn't say it was the wrong thing to do, so why am I in trouble? And these are just three objects that you should not hit your child with: a switch, a Hot Wheels track, and a cable cord. Now, a switch is just a thin branch that makes a hissing noise as you hit. And these are pictures of Adrian Peterson's child. And the reason that he hit his child with a switch is because down south, that's just something that they did, they use switches. But they didn't realize that this is, you know, this leaves physical scars and maybe even emotional scars towards the son, because this is very painful. Obviously, you can see the blood and all that. And the Hot Wheels track was incorporated in two of my favorite TV shows, but it was really negative when I saw it, because I noticed that this is a Hot Wheels track. This is a toy, not like a belt or a hand that you're punishing your child with. And you should be showing this to the public so that they have an idea that they can hit their child with it. And the last thing is a cable cord. Everybody has cable cords laying around the house. So down south, a parent would pick it up and they would use it as a belt and think it's okay. But in general, cable cords are thin and they usually have metal in the end of them, so they leave lasting wounds. And it's very detrimental to your child. So the proper way to spank your child is with their clothes on, and usually one or two spankings, and that's all you need. So I hope you learned that you should spank your child over not spanking your child.